like that. You can see it's identical to the previous layout. We can't tell any difference yet. So I'm going to double click to make that viewport active, unlock the scale, and then I know that my next drawing is to the right, so I'm going to pan, bring that across, and that's my next page set up. Except the title block, I'll double click to go back and change that, and I'll just double click on the title block and change the sheet title to, what is it, classroom. There we go. So you can also give your layouts names if you double click on the layout name. So I'll call this boardroom plan 1 to 50. You can't use colon, so I'm just putting a dash. And then the second one I'll call classroom. There we go. So I'll just repeat that one more time. So again, to copy the layout, I'm going to right click and then go to move or copy, tick create a copy, and then choose move to end, click OK. Now you can see that I can't see the new layout. It is there, but I need to click on these double arrows to show the next one, if you've got too many. And so now, again, I can double click to make that viewport active and then just pan to bring the next view across. I might go back to the page and then change the sheet title to, what is it, conference room? And then again change the layout name as well to match. And there we go, so I've got three new layouts now, but again, I can't see all of them, so I'll click on this double arrow again to bring up the full list, to go back to the first one, and check the second, and then the third. So that's the first stage. I'll do another recording to show how to make the dimensions and text for those layouts as well.